Hello and welcome to Savage Saturday. It's working this time. It's the second time I had to start the stream. First time, I talked about how I had to re-download Spelunky because it stopped working. It was giving me an error. It was the only digital game on my PS4 telling me it could not start. I had to delete it and re-download it. Now it works. And then the webcam wasn't working. It was working in the preview before this when I was testing. Man, I should check that too, huh? Let me check the sound real quick. What's up, Nebula? Give me a second to change this. This sound is way too loud. Alright, let's see. This seems marginally better. Yeah, that should be okay. Let's get some Spelunky on. There it is. Man, this couldn't have any more issues, could it? Holy shit. So I noticed last week, or not last week, 2 weeks ago, that the sound was really low, and you couldn't hear any of the hot Spelunky jams. But this week you should be able to hear him a little bit better, possibly a little bit too well in comparison to my voice. But I've noticed that there was a point where I updated my capture card software and I guess it reset all the defaults, which I did not notice. So like specifically Thursday Throwback for the past couple weeks has been really quiet. I died immediately. That was terrible. That was the worst run we've ever had on a Savage Saturday, I think. But you know, we gotta start somewhere. So this week, we are going to play some Spelunky, as we do most weeks, and then I am going to attempt to learn a little bit more of Invisible Ink. So, what I have played of it so far, I have not particularly been a huge fan of. I knew it was going to be like turn-based, but so far I haven't really been able to get into it. And it seems like a little too ridiculous, even on like the beginner setting. But maybe it's just because I haven't learned enough, so I'll try to learn that for a little bit. Shoot. Wow, that was lucky, huh? Man. We'll drop this down, though. Yeah, let me know if the audio is, like, too loud in comparison to my voice or something like that. I can try to turn it down again. But yeah, audio is, like, the bane of my existence. Like, I like streaming and stuff, but, like, making sure that the audio is okay is a pain in the ass. No, I beat Cyber Sleuth on that stream that you were at last. That was the end of the game, so I had already been playing for like 50 some hours. So I had like a team of max level Digimon, so I'm all set on Cyber Sleuth. What's up, Dragonplay? Darn. Where'd the dog go? Oh, you just chilling down here, dog? Alright. No, I rarely 100% games, especially Cyber Sleuth, because I would have to do a second playthrough. I gave up getting Platinums long ago, unless it's like the world's greatest game or it's really easy. I generally can't. Wow, that was really lucky I didn't get totally dead there. And like, Cyber Sleuth specifically, to get the rest of it, I would literally just have to grind out every single Digivolution. Which, like, I had already done a buttload, so once I had all the really good ones, it wasn't really worth it. God damn this. We're just starting off poo-poo bad here today. We're just getting out of the stage. Well, specifically, I was talking about Invisible Ink, which is another Savage Saturday game. Ooh, good thing I had the parachute. This is bad. Not playing for 2 weeks has made me bad again. I've become bad once again. Throw rocks at everything. Thanks for the pro tip, Micah. Oh, that didn't go up like I wanted it to. But yeah, throwing rocks at things is a pretty good strat. I didn't throw it at that snake, and I lost for it. There's a lot of enemies this week. There is a new Digimon world, but it's not out in English yet. And it probably won't be for like another year or so. I don't know what it is. I'm not feeling very confident today in my spelunking. Oh, dear Lord. That'll do that, I guess. That'll be that second run there. Much better than the first one where I died within the first 30 seconds. But still not that much better in reality. Almost got hit by whatever was in the pot there. Oh, Jesus, God.
Okay.
But yeah, last week, oh my god, this is terrible. I ended up not being home Saturday night, and then when I did get home, I just ended up playing Dark Souls anyways. And I played Bloodborne a little bit when it came out on stream, but I didn't play Dark Souls at all, because people really like to go into streams and just, like, spoil everything with those games, so I tend not to stream when I do them. Are you for real? Oh my god! Ugh. I gotta have at least one not terrible run. So I beat Dark Souls 3, and it was kind of savage. I don't know, I feel like now that it's the third iteration, I had a lot easier time. Like people say Dark Souls is hard, but I mean, I did have trouble with the first one, but I think that's before I really knew, like, the mechanics of the game. And then, like, when 2 came out, I thought 2 was pretty easy. And, like, 3 wasn't that bad. Bloodborne is, like, faster Dark Souls, which is what I did not like very much about Bloodborne, is I generally go with more tanky builds in Dark Souls, so being super light and having none of the armor really matter, and Bloodborne really didn't mesh with the way I play those games. Dark Souls 3, unfortunately, had the same type of thing where you couldn't upgrade armor and it didn't really matter as much. So me being a giant tank man wasn't really as viable as it was in Dark Souls 1 and 2. I did adapt, though. And I mean, I don't know. Dark Souls 3 was good. It's very challenging, yeah. Just like personally, Bloodborne was more challenging for me than Dark Souls because of, I don't know, I never play like a fast dodge build. I always play like a giant tank man with a great sword. And I like that. And that's one of the things that kind of bummed me out a little bit about Dark Souls 3 was, like, I couldn't really play that way for the whole game. I actually had to switch out my build, which I think, like, that's just, I don't know, in some cases it's like if they wanted to make a boss hard, so they just made it fast as shit, and, like, that's not necessarily the best way to balance it, I don't think. But I am not a game designer. I like Dark Souls 3 though. It was good. It was a good conclusion to the Dark Souls trilogy. So yes, Dragonplay. Dank Souls was pretty good. I still, I beat every optional boss and every boss in the game except for one, who seems to be widely considered to be the hardest boss in the game. And that's just because I tried him a couple times, and then I went and I beat the game, and I had had my fill for a little bit. I'll go back and try to beat him at some point, but probably not for a little bit. Maybe when the DLC comes out? Because there should be, like, 2 DLC packs. I'm actually kind of disappointed in myself. I didn't just, like, play Dark Souls for a Savage Saturday. I could still do that, theoretically, when the DLC comes out or something. Because when those games want to be savage to you, they do it, man. They just, like, some of the stuff gets you when you're coming around a corner, or just like, wow, I didn't think that hit would just completely obliterate me, but it did. Stuff like that. They're really good, though. It's a great series, and I mean, like, it's cool that they tried something new with Bloodborne and then brought some of the stuff they learned back into Souls. Oh god. That was bad. But you know, I guess I'm more in this trying to go for like roguelike type stuff. So. What? That was stupid. Oh my god, this is all bad. Get in there. I would have tried to get that box, but then it would have been bad. All right, well, you know, it can't be that bad if you make it to the ice caves, right? And I actually have a decent amount of bombs and hearts. I feel like this run was butt. Oh, yeah, remember when I angered Kali? Because I sure don't. I didn't do anything to your stupid idol. Ugh. Now the game's got the spiders all over the place. I watched the monster anime when I was in college, so like, at this point, probably 4 years ago I watched Monster, because it wasn't during my senior year. Yeah, I like Monster though, it's a good anime. Oh yes, and we got the smooth jazz. I think we could go get the Doge. Yeah. Alright. Wait, it's down there? Shit. Oh, shit. Hey, he opened a path! Alright, my mans! I know, Dragonfly. I was clearly over there chucking bombs all day, every day. Nothing could stop me. Dragonfly, have you been playing Spelunky still, or did you just give it a shot and then choose you liked watching better? Ooh, that sucks, kind of. That was shitty, and that's gonna hit me, isn't it? Yep. Damn. Alright, I'm gonna try to come in from over there. Oh, I don't have the spike shoes. Boy, that was dumb. Oh, man. Okay, it's down there. Oh, yeah, man. Co-op. I've never been able to do co-op. I've also tried to do co-op, and yeah. Oh, shit! Shiitake mushroom! Oh, get punted! I was almost at the temple, dang it. But yeah, co-op is rough. I can't do co-op. I guess to be fair though, the last time I did play co-op, it was with one of my friends who really likes to troll. So he was, like, kind of doing poorly on purpose to see if he could make me angry. But, yeah, I don't know. It's at least fun to try, I think, in co-op. I've actually watched, like, legit co-op runs, and they're pretty cool when the people actually, like, mesh well together and they know what they're doing, and they're, like, both super good. It's crazy. Gotta use a bomb to get the dog. Not likely. It's only 1-1. Jumped down at the exact same time and fell on spikes. Huh, that's rough. Really? A cobra? That hitbox was dumb. I had to be in, like, the exact right position to get smacked by that. Oh, I threw the rock up there again. That was worth it. It's a wonderful time. Oh, God. Yeah, I don't know. I have mixed feelings about trying Invisible Ink, because it's one of those things where it's like Crypt of the Necrodancer, I really have to focus, so it's not necessarily a good stream game for me personally. But Invisible Ink, man, there's so many variables, and it's like kind of slow because it's turn-based. It's, I don't know. I'll see. We'll have to see. No Spelunky, though. I still, man, every day I go to the PlayStation blog and I wait for their announcement of Downwell because I'm so hyped and I want Downwell so bad. And I mean, Downwell costs like $2 on Steam all the time, so I could just get it there and play it there, but... ugh. Not going over there. Look at that scorpion. See, I don't know, I'm just trying to think of stuff now. As we talked about Savage Saturday, how I had trouble booting up Spelunky before. I had to re-download it for some stupid reason. I'm gonna try Invisible Ink later. I've been playing a lot of Enter the Gungeon. Holy shit. I'll probably do that in Spelunky next week, because, man, Enter the Gungeon is awesome. It's like a roguelike that's nice to you. And, like, sometimes, like, Spelunky, I love to death, but, like, sometimes you lose a run and you're like, man, my soul is dead now, and I have to stop playing Spelunky for a little bit. Enter the Gungeon, like, I always want to go right back in, so it's, like, it's been pretty dangerous. Like, if I try not to start playing, like, if I'm, like, within an hour of going to bed, because then I know I'm just going to keep playing it and not stop. I get, like, a one more run type of mentality. So if you want to try out a roguelike... / roguelite that's like pretty accessible and like kind of fun, I highly recommend Enter the Gungeon. Oh boy. This turned poor. It was poor. It was not good. Oh no. Oh no. Oh, fudge. What? It flew right at me. Yeah, it was, so I tried Enter the Gungeon for Savage Saturday 2 weeks ago, and I was like, I thought it was okay then, but then I kept going, and like, you just keep unlocking stuff at such a rapid clip that I kept playing. It was, so the day after I did that Savage Saturday, that Sunday, Normally I go somewhere Sunday night and hang out with a couple friends, but we didn't do it that Sunday. So I just played Enter the Gungeon for like... too long, man. That was crazy. And then when, since Dark Souls 3 came out, I took a little bit of a break. But now that I've beaten Dark Souls, I think I'm gonna start going hard and Enter the Gungeon again. Because there's nothing else right now that I really want to play. Oh, I killed the dog. God damn it. Because, like, Uncharted comes out in, like, 2 weeks. I imported Gundam Breaker 3, which comes out next week, but since it's an import from Asia, I won't get it for a while. Gotta build those Gundam models, man. I'll definitely stream that. Okay, well, you know, I hit my goal. I made it to the ice caves. So after this terrible run, we'll do the daily, and then I'll try to switch over to Invisible Ink, just so I can try to explain what I understand of the mechanics so far and see if I can beat a stage or two before calling it a stream. So, I think, I don't know, I gotta try more Invisible Ink. Just in my off time from streaming as well. Because, like, when I tried it, I had just beaten Dark Souls 3. And then I was, like, kind of tired and, like, a little frustrated. So it's, like, not the best time to absorb knowledge. Oh my god, that was butt. But we'll try the daily anyways. What? Oh man, another thing about the before the stream that couldn't have possibly gone more wrong. I have been using my phone for chat, so I have to look down and it looks really weird and unnatural because I keep looking down at my phone. So I was gonna have my laptop, right? And then right before the stream started, my laptop decided it would be the perfect time to upgrade to Windows 10 without consenting me at all. So now my laptop is still over there upgrading to Windows 10, and it probably won't even be done by the time I am done streaming, which is annoying because I wanted to watch the new episodes of One Piece on it, but I probably won't be able to do that for at least another hour or so. And what's annoying is, like, this is the second time I have two computers, and now both of them have upgraded to Windows 10 without me telling them to, and actually explicitly telling them not to. I didn't do it on my PC at first because I was worried that it would kind of screw up OBS and my streaming setups, but it didn't, luckily. The reason I didn't do it on my laptop is because my laptop is kind of older, and definitely is going to chug with Windows 10 on it a little bit. Which is a pain in the butt. I really only use that to surf the internet and watch downloaded videos, though, so, like, that won't be that big a deal. It's just annoying that it did it without my consent. It was amazing, too, because I clicked a video on my hard drive, I opened it, and then the screen was just like, I'm restarting, and we're going to install Windows 10. I was like, cool, thanks. I didn't at all want to watch the video I had just clicked. And it's even more insane because I just recently factory reset this laptop and there's like nothing on it. So the fact that it's taking this long to update to Windows 10 is a little disconcerting. Just go. Dark stages are butts. We all know this. Ooh, hit the mic. Don't do that. Wow, there's a lot of snakes. Oh shoot, this is the daily. That's a real bummer. We're gonna get like bottom of the leaderboards. Man, remember last time I did the daily on stream? I thought I did so well, and then we were like in last place overall. That was so sad. I cried a little bit. No. Okay, we killed him. Nice. Oh, I did get the spike shoes. Good for me. Ah, dang it. Oh, don't die, dog. I need your health. Okay. You know, every time for a daily, actually, every time I get to Jungle 2, I feel satisfied because... The kids cry. But yeah, like, you're right, Dragonplay. Like, at this point, everybody who's still playing Spelunky on like the daily is like pretty good at the game by now. Oh god, that was, why did I think I could jump on that? That was insane. They're usually like ghost mining using advanced strats, so I'm usually never gonna get there unless I get very lucky. Let's see what that was, because that was terrible. 44? Who's playing the daily? What is happening? How do we... What happened to these people? Only 88 people played it so far. Okay, well, we at least came in the halfway point of all the people who have tried so far. These people got $0? They get $0. Like, literally must have spawned and then died. Anyways, that's Spelunky. We're gonna switch over to a new game, Invisible Ink. And like I said, I'm having mixed feelings about this one. So, let's try and see what happens. And now, let me see, I just gotta switch over the game on Twitch real quick. Well, I thought I was gonna be able to do it on my laptop. I was wrong. Did it really start working as soon as I set it down? Is that a thing that's happening? Shouldn't take this long. Alright,
fine.
Screw you, laptop. I was right. I was right. I'm always right. That's a good sign. My laptop's just loading into a black screen. Come on. All right, updated that. We're here in Invisible Ink. So, what this game is? It is a roguelike. Once you lose completely, it is over. You have to start over. So it's a little bit different though, because you're not just one character. You're controlling a set of agents. And once all the agents
I've
get defeated,
contact with monster. His network picked up the attack just before.
Okay, I'm just gonna skip all this
Thank
stuff because I've seen it. Once all your agents die, you lose. And so I started a new game. What happens is you are going after a group of enemy agents who attack your HQ. And so each mission has a certain difficulty rating, and you want to try to go to get in there, steal stuff, or do whatever it wants you to do, and get out with your agents alive and intact. And with the money and credits you get and the things you get, you level up your agents. I don't necessarily know what the greater goal is yet, but we're gonna try. We'll go in here just so I can kind of...
The corporations are technically at war with each other, but reality is much more complex. Executives maintain extensive intercorporate connections as they defect back and forth.
Facility is guarded by civilian level security forces. Okay, that's true. This game's been out on PC for a long time. It just came out on PlayStation 4 this past Tuesday. I gave it a couple of shots. I actually restarted the game, and so if anyone ends up watching this and has played Invisible Ink, I am on the lowest possible difficulty beginner, and I still think it's kind of hard, mainly because I don't know what's going on yet. So each mission will have objectives like this. Like right here, we have the primary objectives. We need to locate and execute terminals, get out alive, and we can also find and steal corporate credits if we want to do that. Okay, and so we have our two agents that I currently have in the beginning of the game. We have Decker, and we have Internationale. And we use the analog stick to move them around like this. They have a certain movement range. And all you can see is, like, this room, right? And so you have to be very stealthy and watch out, because if you get grabbed, your guy gets knocked out. And it basically means they're down, and they could theoretically be lost if you don't get to them within a certain amount of turns. So you can rotate your room here, and there will be red terminals that you can hack and red security cameras. So you have this basically an AI at your disposal called Incognita. So if you look down bottom right hand corner, there are your controls. You have L1, R1 to switch between the agents that you have out. If you hit square with a specific agent, it takes you down to the bottom left, where you can look at the abilities they have and how much action points it costs. You can see how much action points they have above their head. I know this is all a little bit complex if you've never seen it before, but that's just... I don't know. The game's got a lot to it. And so you move them around. Is that a door there? Yeah, no. So you move your agents around to certain things. They can trade items with each other, knock people out. But if you push triangle, you are taken to Incognita, your AI, and she has abilities. So there's that terminal there. I want to hack it. So we have this skill here, Lockpick 1.0, which we can use to hack it. And it costs 2 power. As you can see, we have 10 out of 20 power, and we get 1 power a turn. So we'll hack it. Oh, see, I'm already lying to you. This is how little I know about this game. I have to go up to it and hack it. So we will do that. We'll get Internationale there. Hack the console. We get 2 power from that. She can still move. So we'll have her go over here. And then we will switch to Decker. And so what you have to do is you never know what's in the next room. So you want to get them to the door. And then you want to have them use this peek function. And so you'll be able to see things in the next room, which, as we can see here, this red area is something that's being watched. I would hazard a guess that there is a security camera that I cannot see from the vantage point I'm at, so I'll move in here. And just as I suspected, there is a guard. So we will go to Decker, and we will have him wait as an I think that guard can see him. We'll have him go here, and we'll have him wait as an ambush. So now, if the guard walks by, Decker will use his taser to knock him out for a couple turns. And so we're all good here. I don't want to move right now. We will end our turn. And each turn, the security level increases, so that's a pain in the butt. But we will get Decker over here to knock this guy out. So now he's down for a little bit. Fuck. Okay. So there's a security camera in the corner. We definitely want to hack that. It looks like there's also a safe, which we can get money out of. But we want to hack the security camera. So that way we can have free reign of this room. We'll take Internationale, we'll move her over here. Wireless scanner. See, there's so many things I don't know. I feel like there's a lot I have to learn. But as I said, I'm playing on beginner difficulty, so it gives me 5 rewinds. So like if I get caught by a dude, I can rewind and go back. So it helps take the stress off. But there are at least 5 difficulty levels that I could see. We'll hack this safe also. So once you hack a safe, you gotta have one of the agents go up to it and take stuff from it. Got 150 credits. Oh, dang it, you can't peek if all your AP is gone. So we can't see what's in the next room. There is a guard, though. I can hear him moving around. Wait, what? Ah, fuck me.
Did you see that?
Okay. So this is a strat that I learned in the tutorial. Oh no! I didn't apply the strat properly, but we will still do it. Basically, if there is a guard in the next room and you open the door, they'll get curious and they'll come see. And so now we have Internationale waiting. Lying in wait. He'll come in. We'll jack him. And there we go. Oh, shit. He woke up, huh? That's not good. So he'll probably come over here and be like, man, that sucks. I got knocked out. What's the deal with that? And he might wake up this guard, so that's a problem. We're gonna have to try to get in and get out here. I can already tell I'm gonna lose this mission. They've cracked Incognita's first layer of encryption. Be careful, the next alarm level will be quite dangerous. Okay. And so what sucks is, I like when the agents are together, but eventually you kind of have to split up, and so at the end of every stage, there's an elevator for you to get out, but you have to meet your objective first. So, like, that's good. Our objective seems to be right here in this room. So we'll end our turn. We'll go in there. You know, you probably can drag bodies away. I don't necessarily know how. Or it's possible that it's a skill. So you get those credits at the end of every mission. You can use the credits to buy items and... abilities for your guys. Just get in the area. Huh, he didn't wake up that guy? I feel like that's something that you would do. Gotta get that sweet, sweet data. What does it say? The terminal is loaded with info that can be used to find locations for future incursions, but it's all encrypted. While Incognita downloads a large chunk of encrypted data, you've got time to dig for a site of your choosing. Oh, boy. The corporation at this location is keeping a high-value item under heavy security. Item which normally costs a lot. Greater rewards for future locations. Highest value items are behind locked doors. I can't get behind locked doors. Which mission type provides key benefits to your agents? All new locations will be presented to you over time. Successful infiltration will speed up the process and give you more targets. We'll go with the financial suite.
Good job. You've got the site list. They noticed you poking about and have changed up their patrols. Be careful on your way out.
You know, have you wait there just in case homeboy comes over.
Oh, what happened?
Shit, they both woke up. There's the elevator. Guessing we can get in there. Let's wait and see.
Investigating.
Oh shit, there's a gentleman over there, huh? You wait in ambush. You come over here. Close that door. Can we hack this? Nope. We can hack this. Can I have him get that? 150 credits. Enter. Wait, what? Oh, he saw her. Shit. That's his whole radius, huh? See? There, she died. So normally in a regular game, that would be the end of it. But we will rewind. Because I suck. How was I supposed to know he'd be able to see her from there? I thought that my mans would get her. So yeah, okay. So we had the right idea. I think it's a cool mechanic to like teach you the basics. Because then you can, at least, like, you're not just totally boned. Got him.
Alarm level 2. Additional cameras
See, like, this is what I don't get is, like, why is this door locked? I'm gonna have to wait another turn, because...
Investigating area.
This guy's right here. What? We're gonna be doing this for a billion turns. Oh, dear Christ! Go! Okay, drag security guard. You were right, Dragonplay. We will steal his valuables. That's a guard elevator. Okay, so we have to continue on our way. Shit, that guy knows we're here, though. There's our elevator. There's our escape. So I'm gonna guess that guy won't get up for a couple turns. What does this get us? Server terminal. Okay, that's not worth it. So we're just gonna run for the exit, because we got what we need. Oh, that wasn't actually the exit, son of a bitch. This place is huge. Okay, that's the elevator. And we can actually get in there, so thank God. Oh, wow. Oh shit, homeboy woke up. So she can escape now, which we will have her do. We'll wait till they both get in the elevator. And see, we made it out.
That contact list will prove invaluable when planning our next move. Excellent work.
Now, like, that took forever. And it's kind of slow. It is a cool game. I don't know that it's, like, good for streaming, necessarily. Alright, we got an incoming message from our merchant here.
I think we're getting somewhere. Monster will explain.
You guys are good at covering your tracks. You've been hitting the cops for years, but they've never been able to follow you home. I guess they were too distracted fighting each other to bother. Or maybe you were considered a useful pawn. Enemy of my enemy and all that.
What we do well.
Well, you must have finally done something to get their undivided attention. They were able to pinpoint your HQ by linking their surveillance nets. That's unprecedented. Not for the usual bullshit political reasons, but because of the sheer computational power required.
One that could host Incognita.
Right. If you put your AI on that network, it would have an incredible degree of access.
Enough to wipe their security records and put Invisible back underground.
More like enough to force them underground. And who knows what else? But that's jumping ahead. We have to find it first. They're still looking for you, but they're not hiding the fact anymore. Each time you do an infiltration, Global SecNet lights up like a Christmas tree. Do that enough times, and we should be able to cross-ref.
And then we can swell then. It's time for us to...
Okay, so it seems like that is the greater goal, is they want you to keep doing missions until... you can find where their base is, so you can put Incognita there. And, like, I don't know. This game seems really cool. I, in theory, should like it. I feel like I just have to play it more. So, let's see what we can, like, upgrade here. How do I got an incoming message from Monster. There it is.
I've got something you might be interested in. I need a quick decision. This thing's hot.
A favorite of script kiddies and low-level corporate admins, the Buster Chip automatically breaks down firewalls. Use this to manually break through 3 firewalls. Ah, I'm good. Okay, so you can use credits to upgrade their stats. Yeah, speed, hacking, strength, and anarchy. Steal from behind, steal. Anarchy is about stealing. Strength is improved drag speed. You can carry more items. Hacking is you're just better at hacking. Speed adds more movement. So, like, you can upgrade your dudes in that way. And like I said, you're using credits for all this, so.
It's about something you might be interested in. I need a quick decision. This thing's hot.
She can hack items at a distance. You can uncover daemons and adjacent objects. I don't even know what the hell that means. He needs more strength. She needs more speed. And we'll go with that. Is there a way for me to save? I'm gonna hit save and exit just so I can save. But yeah, what's crazy about this is, like, you can be playing somewhere for a long time. We already read this.
Enough to
did
wipe
it not save my
and then well
save what I did? You can be playing for a long time and then all your agents just get jacked and you're, like, totally boned, so.
Not all nanofabs are created equal. The one at this location is a more versatile model used to make more complex items. Just think of the wonderful toys.
Okay. So I'll do this mission and then we'll call it.
Agents report to transport pads. Now.
And I wonder how you get more agents, because there's definitely slots for more agents. Oh, like right there. Looks like we got Nika Muratova, Tony Zhu. Alright, and we'll split them up this time. I already feel like I'm getting slightly better. Daemons are offensive AI programs that protect mainframe devices. They will trigger when you hack the device. Different daemons have different effects, but all of them will hurt. Be careful. Interesting. And his ability is he can figure out the daemons. What the hell? Why is that room still under surveillance? Aha! Because there's an enemy hidden in sight. Hopefully one of the things you can buy is more stun. Because boy, they're not stunned for very long. Alright, so he's ready. He's just ambushing. Oh, nope. Now he's ambushing. We will open this door. Oh no, it was another security camera. The game lied to me. It said it was a hidden guy. Well, that's fine. And I am also hoping that you can get items that kill people. I mean, I know it's all about stealth, but like, the ability to harm people would be nice. So that way they don't get up. Turn. Okay, so there is a guy. Nope, not you. Wait, the guy didn't notice? What? Okay. Is that our... Nope, Daemon database. Well, you gotta hack it twice. Damn it. Interesting. So now all the daemons will be hidden. Aye, boy. No idea where I'm going. I want to try to get them closer together. Fuck. That was my bad. Rewind. God damn it. I shouldn't have even had to do that rewind. Here, we will close this door so he doesn't come right after us. Here. What are you doing? Eek. There's the exit.
Warning.
I feel like I should always have them getting ready for an ambush. I don't know. Where the fuck did he go? Oh no. Oh no. This is all bad.
Did you see that?
She was supposed to attack him. He's elite. What? Since he's armored, I can't do that to him. That sucks. I don't know what I'm supposed to do at that point then. What do you do at that point? I guess I have to observe his movements? Okay, I guess I just gotta stand right there, otherwise she can't see him anymore. Oh, fuck me. That's not good. Is that guy an elite? What? This shit's crazy. Possibly the guy with more strength. I'll have to see. I can't like get.
Investigating.
Yeah, see, this unit will shoot at movement during the enemy's turn, but they don't have guns. So I think I can only do that with guns. Alright, let's... Shit, man! What do I do? Actually, it looks like I can hack this device to buy things. Maybe I can buy a gun? Tag pistol. Nope. Requires certain skill levels. Man, we might just have to call this one a loss. Ignores armor. Yeah, it reveals his patrol path, but like, what difference does that make? Oh shit, I didn't know I was moving her. Ooh, the frame rate got a little dicey there. Try again.
What the?
Oh shit. He's gonna have to. Oh boy.
Investigating area. I must be jumpy tonight.
Alarm level 2.
Shit.
Additional cameras activated. The walls have eyes.
Christ, if this unit dies, requires armor-piercing weapons. How do I... Oh, God.
Unlocked a nanofab located. We found what we came for.
Wait, so I did it? Question mark?
Warning.
Is there a way for me to objectives, get out alive, access the nanofab vestibule. Well, we'll try that again. We'll see. Oh, okay. There's a lot of stuff. Melee weapons. dart hand cannon. No armor piercing. But this item does not pierce armor. Item does not pierce armor. Armor piercing 2. Armor piercing 1. I don't have them. I don't have enough money for either one of those credits. Okay, we just got to get out alive now.
We must have triggered something in their telemetry. They're toggling the power on to some of the devices we've taken.
Fucking what? How are we gonna get her out of there? Can she sprint if she's got full? Oh, nice! Okay. I don't think he can move that far.
Looking around.
Investigating.
Yeah, totally! Oh, somehow I made it out! Alright, I do like this game more than the last time I played it. I gotta learn.
Nothing to your liking. I'm sorry, I'll try finding you a more upscale boutique.
Oh, shut up. Listen. I didn't have enough money. How was I gonna get it? Oh, I actually accomplished nothing from that mission. Cool. Well, you know, this game seems cool. Gotta keep going.
Now we're getting somewhere. Where did you find this thing anyway?
Incognita was built back in the 40s by the pan-European government to run climate models. When the war broke out, she was retrofitted to predict troop movement.
Funny. You never strike me as an anthropomorphizing type.
And you've never struck me as particularly charitable. And yet here you are, helping us out.
I guess we all have our weaknesses.
And yeah, I would assume there's missions to get more, more guys from a detention center and stuff like that. I don't know. I'm gonna have to keep playing this. I just gotta learn. I'll bring it back one of these weeks. But it takes a bit and it's kind of slow. Like that one I said that was gonna be my last one. I assumed it would only take like 5-10 minutes. It took like 15 almost. But yeah, I don't know. It's interesting. I gotta look up more about it. Next week, I will be back with more Spelunky and possibly some Enter the Gungeon. Probably some Enter the Gungeon. And then the week after, I might bring this back just so that I can show you what I have learned. But yeah, Monster does seem like the main bad guy. He seems pretty suspicious, giving us all his monies. I wish I had a way to show the beginning cinematic. Possibly if I start a new game or something, I could show it, but their base gets invaded. It's a pretty cool, stylized cutscene. But yeah, thank you for watching. This has been Spelunky and Invisible Ink Console Edition. I will see you guys next week with more Savage Saturday. Peace.